What do you have when you combine a great do-it-yourself project with SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation? You have fun. Architect and founder of Homemade Modern, Ben Ueda, brings eco-friendly designs to the masses. The Homemade Modern website features blogs and videos that showcase these designs. One of his videos is of a wood-fired hot tub. This is made out of components found at any local hardware store. This design really piqued my interest. At the end of his video, Ben proposed multiple ideas to improve the hot tub design. Possibly adding another coil or increasing the tubing diameter would help heat the hot tub faster. Another option would be to add a stove-like enclosure to the fire to help with fuel efficiency. Wanting to prove these theories, I decided to build a wood-fired hot tub of my own. But where?
My wife said no to the backyard. I didn't even ask about the front, or anywhere else for that matter.
Being shut down on the physical project, I compromised with a more wife-friendly option. Let's prove out Ben's suggestions virtually. Using SOLIDWORKS computer-aided design software, we can create a digital clone of Ben's hot tub.
I began by creating a 3D model inside SOLIDWORKS and ended up with 5 different assembly versions, also called configurations. An assembly is a collection of parts put together inside the software, just like you would create the hot tub in real life. Here we see the baseline model that mimics the hot tub in the Homemade Modern video. Changing the dimension of the copper coil's diameter is one of Ben's suggestions and is the second version. The third option was a snap to create. I added a second heat source and coil with the pattern command. The pattern feature makes reuse of geometry fast and easy. Because the fittings were created as a smart feature, the fitting has a cut associated with it. The fitting dictates the hole location in the tub. No need to modify the geometry. The hole follows the fitting. As easy as placing an enclosure over the fire in your backyard, adding an enclosure inside of SOLIDWORKS creates the fourth configuration. I have my own theory on how to improve heating. Doubling the number of copper coils with the original half-inch diameter tube should add more surface area for the heat of the fire to reach. This makes the fifth version to test. Creating 5 configurations in one model makes it easy and simple to keep track of all the variants.
With the first step of generating the model complete, the next step is to virtually simulate heating the water with the fire. The computational fluid dynamics of SOLIDWORKS flow simulation mathematically solves for the behavior of the water in the hot tub and the air surrounding it.
The free surface capability of flow simulation keeps track of where the water and air interact. The analysis starts with the tub and coil filled with water just above the top inlet. A heat source is added to the fire, and the thermodynamics begin. The control study mimics the real-world version Ben created. Flow simulation accurately depicts the heat transfer that drives the flow of the water. The solver window gives live feedback showing the progress of the flow study as it solves. The baseline flow simulation study is easily duplicated and applied to each variant of the hot tub. This allows reusing boundary and initial conditions.
Here we see the baseline result and how the 4 variations stack up. Note that the starting temperatures, heat source temperature, and material properties were kept consistent throughout all 5 studies. Flow simulation provided a virtual clone to Ben's original hot tub setup. Solving for the movement of water due to natural convection, this study provides an excellent data set. Comparing the results at the same elapsed time allows for a fair apples-to-apples comparison. The 2-fire, 2-coil hot tub version provides the highest overall temperature in the most even temperature distribution. A close second is the stove closure configuration. This option showed a high temperature close to the inlet and would require some agitation to even the temperature throughout the hot tub. The stove enclosure configuration would require more heating time than the 2-fire option to reach the same temperature. Doubling the number of coils provides a larger amount of surface area for heat transfer to take place. This heats the water at a faster rate, making this a third place hot tub option in comparison to the control configuration from Ben's video. Interestingly, the larger coil diameter setup using 3/4 inch tubing provided less hot water than the baseline setup. Because a larger diameter coil contains more fluid volume but relatively the same surface area, more thermal energy or more exposed time to the heat source is required to heat the water to the same temperature. So why is this comparison important? Flow simulation allowed me to test a variety of different options without physically building multiple hot tubs in my backyard. This kept my wife happy, my wallet full, and allowed me to answer which of Ben's suggestions worked the best. The top modification that gets you in the hot tub faster is the addition of a second heating coil and fire. Quicker heating time
equals less wasting time.
Virtual testing is used all over the engineering world. It helps reduce the amount of costly prototypes and shortens the time to market. Thanks to Ben for providing such a cool idea. Please contact Computer Aided Technology if you have any questions about utilizing virtual prototypes. Certainly contact me if you build a wood-fired hot tub. I'd love to check it out.